Of our chapter, which is volume and surface area of prisms and cylinders. Today I am here with a new question, which would be a bit different from the other questions. So let's start. Here it is, a question number one, that a cuboid has a dimension of 28 centimeter by b centimeter by 15 centimeter, has a volume of 6720 cm cube. So if you note this data, that we have one dimension missing and the volume is given. So this is some sort of a case discussed earlier in the previous video, but also I will recall it here as well. After that, the second part is the new one, that the cuboid is melted to form a smaller cubes of length 4 centimeter. So we need to calculate how many cubes that it can make. What do you mean by this part number two would be explained a bit later. First of all, let's solve part one, that is finding the breadth. As volume is provided to you, so you can use the formula for volume first and you can calculate the missing dimension. So first of all, note down the data, which is length is equals to 28 centimeters, breadth is b, height is 15 centimeters, and volume is 6720 cm cube. So now let's look at the formula, which is volume of cuboid is length into breadth into height. So length, breadth, height, all three dimensions are here, which where b is missing, that is breadth. So so here's the data again, and now we have substituted it in the equation, that is volume is equals to length into breadth into height. Volume was 6720 given in the question, length is 28 also given in the question, breadth is b, and height is 15. So breadth is missing. So first of all, we will multiply 28 and 15, and then we will take it to the other side of the equals to, and then as it is multiplying here, there it will be divided. Or other than that, you can take it in the bracket, that this will be solved first, and then it will be divided by 6720. So the answer would be 16 centimeter of the breadth. So now we have all the dimensions. That was the first part of our question. But in the second part, we are asked, if we need to make this particular cube, and we melt our previous shape, which was the cuboid. If we melt this cuboid and we shape it in the form of cubes of 4 centimeter dimension like this one, how many cubes we can obtain? So we should remember this, that if we melt a particular shape, which is a cuboid in this case, so the volume, total volume remains the same, or the volume remains always same. So if I say that if we melt that cuboid, the volume would be the same, and then we will shape it into cubes, and there will be many cubes present because of that volume. So when we talk about this particular shape, this particular volume, if we take out the volume of this particular cube and we multiply it many times, then we can obtain that volume which we have discussed earlier. So let's solve this first to make the understanding better, that the volume of this cube which we need to make is has the formula length into length into length, which is L cube, and all the dimensions are same, that is 4 centimeter. So length is 4 centimeter and volume is L cube, as the formula for cube is L cube, and the difference of cube and cuboid is that cube has all the same dimensions and cuboid have a different dimensions. So we have put the length over in the formula, which was L cube. So 4 cube is 64 cm cube. So if we want to make a cube of 4 centimeter, so we need a volume of 64 cm cube. So if we have many cubes like this, so 64 cm cube for the first cube, then the second cube is also 64 cm cube, and then so on. So we can have many cubes, but our limit was the volume which was of cuboid. So because that is the only material we are using. So we can say that that all the volumes when it will be added, it will be equal to the volume of the cuboid. So in order to take out the number of cubes that you can make, you can actually divide both the values, that the volume of cuboid and the volume of cube, to obtain how many cubes you can have. So I have shaped it in this formula, that number of cube is total volume of cuboid divided by volume of each cube. That is, total volume of cuboid is 6720 and volume of cube is 64. So I have divided it and I have obtained 105 cubes. That means if I melt that cuboid which was having a volume of 6720 cm cubes, and we make a cube of 64 centimeter cube, then we can have 105 cubes of 4 centimeter dimension. So this was the first question, and now moving to the second question, which is very similar with the first question. That is, a rectangular block of metal is 0.24 meters long, 0.19 meters wide, and 0.15 meters high. If the metal block is melted to form a cube, find the length of each side of the cube. So now it is saying that we have a rectangular block which is obviously cuboid, and the volume is not given, but that all the dimensions are given, that is length, breadth and height. So we can first find the volume of that particular cuboid, and then we can say that the volume of the cuboid would be same as the sum of the volume of cubes. So first of all, let's make the data that length is 0.24 meters, breadth is 0.19 meters, height is 0.15 meters, and we need to find the volume of cuboid first and then the length of cube. So length of cube will be discussed a bit later. First of all, let's find the volume of the cube, a cuboid, that is length into breadth into height. So volume of cuboid is length into breadth into height. I have substituted all the values and I have multiplied it to get the result of the volume of the cuboid, that is 0.00684 meter cubes. So this is the volume of the cuboid, and if we need to make a cube out of this block, we need to make a single cube out of this block. So that means the volume of cuboid would be equal to the volume of that cube. That means if the cuboid was having different dimensions, but the cube will have the same dimensions, that is length, breadth, height, all same. So we need to just mold it, that rectangular block, into a squaric block, that is a cube, that will be a cube. So the volume of cuboid would be equal to the volume of cube, that is 0.00684 meter cube, that is done here. So now, as the volumes are equal, so we can put the formula of volume of cube, which is L cube. We can substitute the value of 0.00684 meter cube, and then we can find the length. So here it is. Volume of cube is L cube. Volume of cube, the value is 0.00684, and here is L cube. Now we need to get rid of this cube. So we will take the cube roots both sides, and the cube root would be cancelled, and the cube root of this particular value 0.00684, and we can calculate it to find the length of the cube, that is 0.19 meters. So it concludes that if we have a rectangular block of such dimensions and we need to find the side of the cube, if we need to convert a single cuboid into a single cube, we can use these formulas in this way to convert it, and the length is turned out to be 0.19 meters in this case. So you can practice such questions more, and you can ask for more questions or more explanation if you have any query. Thank you, everyone.